midst of nature's garden stands our alma mater dear, stately edifice of culture and learning through the years. Past us rolls the mighty river, wooded acres of its shores. God has formed a perfect background for the school that we adore. May the Hudson's sparkling waters surging onward to the sea symbolize the depths and passion of loyalty to thee. Rugged crags and towering mountains in the distance meet the sea. We will climb with you to guide us. So hail, all hail to Dobbs Ferry.
Thank you. President Adam Galland for the Pledge of Allegiance, and we'll also ask that you all remain standing for the singing of the National Anthem by our octet and a cappellas, led today by our choral director, Georgia DeFalco. Wow.
Good morning, Dobbs Ferry High School. Today is it's June the 18th. It's graduation day. It's not an A, B, C, or D day. But please stand and join me for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Welcome all of you once again to the 2022 Dobbs Ferry High School graduation. The students who are sitting here before us today were sophomores when schools were closed in March of 2020. And since that time, they have had obstacle after obstacle to contend with. So I guess in some ways, it's somewhat fitting that we're now going through a final graduation where we're dealing with what feels like 40-mile-an-hour winds. There are many people who I'd like to thank before we get started here. There are so many people who have had a direct role, not only in our graduates sitting before us here today, but also putting on this event. Our first that I would like to recognize is our superintendent, Dr. Lisa Brady. As everybody knows at this point, Dr. Brady is leaving us after serving as our superintendent for the past 11 years. She's been an advocate for all students in our district. She has been a mentor to so many of us, a friend to so many of us. We wish her the very best and thank her for her dedicated years of service. I would like to also welcome and thank our Board of Education, Brooke Bass, Massimo Buffini, Rita Kennedy, Gene Casey, Penny Sullivan Nunez, Vice President Shannon Stringer, and Board President Tracy Barron. We have a dedicated Board of Education who has been a constant support of not only our entire district, but also our high school. And they have had a direct role in the programs that have led to the success of our students sitting here today. Our school counselors, Ms. Silk, Mr. Percy, Mr. Palmer, for their 24/7 dedication to all aspects of our students' lives over the past 4 years in our high school. And that has been especially on display as we've navigated some difficult times and our students have really needed additional support. They've been unbelievable.
Thank you all for being here. Class advisors, all four of them, with a special shout out to Dana
Malloy, who is here today, our senior class advisor. Maria Donna, our president of activities branch. Maria is all things Dobbs Ferry. I think everybody here probably knows Maria. She is the leader of our Dobbs Ferry High School Spirit Squad. She does everything.
When it comes to all aspects of all of the student affairs as it comes to our high school, and even right up until this moment, she's pinning down all of our hoods in the back. So if this hood stays down this whole time, I can thank Maria Donna for that. The PTSA for their ongoing support of our high school and our district and all of the programs, along with our Dobbs Ferry Schools Foundation, Spring and Trail Guides. Principal Julia Drake, Dr. Julia Drake, from the Springhurst class of 2015. Principal Patrick Mussolini from the middle school class of 2018. Along with Assistant Superintendent Dr. Ron Clamser, Assistant Superintendent Dr. Daryl Stinchcomb, Director of Special Education Jean Gizmervik, Director of Technology Terrence Hyder, and Athletic Director Andrew Clanch. The Dobbs Ferry Police Department for their continued support and partnership with our high school, with a special thank you to Dobbs Ferry Officer Stephen Betts from the Dobbs Ferry High School class of 2011, Sergeant Justin Kamke from the Dobbs Ferry High School class of 1995, and of course, Chief Rick Rivera, Kevin Ridley doing the navigating the winds right now as he's filming this for us, Mike Nemeth, for leading our security team, Dean Scott Petrillo, for doing all things Dobbs Ferry as well, including being here early this morning to help to get us set up for this. Our facilities crew, Paul, Phil, Jerome, Benji, Robert, and Keith. And finally, a special thank you to Candace Ream, our assistant principal, Carrie Castanis, our administrative assistant. I think everybody also knows that those two are in many ways the engine behind our high school. Candace and Carrie were out here this morning at 6 a.m. to meet the group with the chairs, along with Candace's son Trevor, setting it up, helping our facilities team. They are true rock stars for us here at the high school, and we couldn't thank them enough. And then, of course, I'd like to thank all of the parents who are here today. You know, there's so much, as all of you know, that go into raising kids. I'm a father of three myself, and it's a 24/7 job. Helping them to navigate through the pandemic was especially challenging, but you all did obviously wonderful jobs, and your children's success today is your success. So we celebrate all of you, our parents, just as we celebrate our graduates. So thank you to all of our parents. At this time, I would like to introduce our Board of Education President, Tracy Barron.
Thank you. We're here today to acknowledge the fantastic people sitting in front of me who have completed their studies and are ready to leave here and blaze a new trail. But there is also someone sitting behind me who has successfully completed something pretty amazing and is about to leave here and blaze a new trail. And that someone is Dr. Lisa Brady, who is retiring, as John said, as superintendent of our schools after 11 years. I couldn't possibly summarize all the things that Dr. Brady has accomplished or all the ways that she has impacted our students and staff. There are just way too many to list. But I think the common thread that connects them all is relationships. Lisa has this incredible ability to build relationships with everyone around her. She remembers names. She writes scores of personal notes to acknowledge milestones and accomplishments. And she organizes book clubs and coffee chats. She can be found at the Rotary Club, the local church, and the senior center. But more importantly, she actually listens, learns, and makes meaningful connections that build trust and understanding. I believe that's why she has been so successful as superintendent. Because when you have strong relationships as your foundation, you empower everyone around you to do great things.
So Lisa, on behalf of all of the people who you have built relationships with, we thank you for your incredible leadership. We wish you a happy and restful retirement.
And we expect you to keep in touch. So please join me in a big Dobbs Ferry thank you to Dr. Lisa Brady.
Special Education Committee and has had a direct hand in ensuring that our Special Education Department continues to best serve our students with disabilities. She has also been directly involved with our district's DEI initiatives since the very beginning and has played a key role in our schools being a place that have allowed our students to grow into powerful advocates, not just for themselves, but also for any of their fellow students who need a helping hand. Ms. Lucchese has two sons, Dylan and Mark, who are graduating today with the class of 2022. It is with great pleasure that I introduce Board of Education member Jean Lucchese.
Thank you, Dr. Foligno. On behalf of the Board of Education,
congratulations to the class of 2022. On this red letter day in your life, in the words of Lin-Manuel Miranda, as his muse, Alexander Hamilton, pride is not the word I'm looking for. There is so much more. Don't get me wrong, let yourselves glory in pride today. It's everywhere. It's your day. And you have so many reasons for pride. You are the smartest, the fastest, the wittiest class. You are the most generous class, the most civic-minded, the most loyal, the most artistic class, and the most musical. Pride in your accomplishments, pride in your plans, pride in your capacity for growth. The class of 2022 has much to be proud of. One point of pride that might have escaped your notice is that one of your classmates became the first person in several years to graduate from Dobbs Ferry High School with a career development and occupational studies credential, otherwise known as CDOS. To get the credential, this young man had to attain 216 work-based learning hours and meet all CDOS learning standards. Kudos to him and to his family. Along with the pride that we have in all of you comes waves of joy at your success. On a personal note, it has been my privilege to get to know many of you, to watch you grow and learn over the years, from karate classes, to Little League, to the middle school musicals, the DC trip, from soccer and lacrosse and Friday night football games, to cross country and track meets. Hope springs from the joy you have sparked. And I speak for my generation when I say that this class inspires hope for a better tomorrow. In the words of Emily Dickinson, hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without the words and never stops at all. Thank you for who you are. I look forward to seeing what you'll do. Congratulations to the class of 2022. Thank you.
So in typical years, my commencement remarks center around reflections of the past 4 years, and usually some parting words of advice for the graduates that I always hope will stick with them as they move on to the next chapter of their lives. But this year, however, I'm going to do it just a little bit differently. So on Wednesday, our seniors walked through the hallways of Springhurst for the final time as students at our Dobbs Ferry schools. So for those of you who don't know, we started this tradition in 2016, and it provides our graduates with one final opportunity to go back to where it all started and to see and thank their former teachers before they move on to the next chapter of their lives. And of course, they get to sing and hear the Springhurst song, I Remember Springhurst, one final time. It's a moment that gets all of us choked up. And no matter how many years Principal Drake and I do that and make that walk, every single time when we go through that cafeteria and hear that song, we get filled up with emotions ourselves because it speaks to the small, special, tight-knit community that we have here in Dobbs Ferry. For the students, it always connects the past with the present. And it includes so many people for them, including their teachers, who directly impacted their lives and helped them to be the graduates that they are sitting here today. So when our current graduates first entered Dobbs Ferry High School in September of 2018, they instantly became part of a rich history and legacy of former Dobbs Ferry students and teachers that dates back to the class of 1934, the first official graduating class who walked the halls of our current school building. I'm now finishing up my 11th year as serving as the principal of our high school. And each year that I serve, I'm more humbled and honored to be part of that history. There were 14 principals who came before me since 1934. And we have also had countless teachers who have served our students and made Dobbs Ferry the place where they have made their life's work. So this year is unique for us, because in addition to all of the graduates sitting before all of us here today, we have a large, for our school, graduating class of teachers, each of whom will be retiring from our school after many years of dedicated service to our students and community. So just as we celebrate our graduates here today and recognize how they are forever part of the legacy of our school, we also celebrate our teachers, who after decades of service to our students and village, are now prepared to move on to the next chapter of their lives. In thinking about each of our retirees, and soon moved on to numerous positions before beginning her first formal assignment in 1993 as a middle school Spanish teacher. In addition to her work inside of the classroom, Ms. Heffler has also been an active member of our village since moving to Dobbs in 1976. She raised both of her daughters in Dobbs Ferry, both of whom are graduates of our high school. She served as the president of the Home and School Association, which is now the PTSA, and she served as the village trustee and deputy mayor of Dobbs Ferry. In addition to being a constant advocate for our students, perhaps the greatest lesson that Ms. Heffler provides our graduates is the importance of serving and giving back locally. Ms. Heffler worked to inspire our students to give beyond themselves, to serve the local community while thinking globally, as we do as IB students, and leaving your local community a better place. Thank you, Ms. Heffler, for your years of dedicated service. And our final retiree is hiding out in the back. And he's been dazzling students in room 311 of Dobbs Ferry High School since 1983. For the past 39 years, Mr. Neil Abitiello has truly graced all of us, regardless of whether or not we were privileged to have him as a teacher. Mr. A, as his students call him, has an amazing ability to bring out the very best in all students, and truly believes that all students can be exceptional in anything that they do if they believe in themselves and are provided with the right amount of positive encouragement. He took this approach not only as a math teacher, but also as a basketball and varsity softball coach in our district, and also as a father of three Dobbs Ferry graduates, Andrea, Allie, and Neil. But despite all of that, and all of Mr. A's talent and his overall popularity with everyone, if you know him at all, you definitely know that right now he's completely uncomfortable with me talking about him like this, and that's why he's standing in the back. And that is perhaps the greatest lesson that our graduates can take from Mr. A, humility. In life, it is never necessary to seek accolades as good you think you may be if you are truly great at what you do. If you work hard, get good results, and have passion for what you do, others will notice, and you will not have to tell them. This is the very essence of being a true leader, and it is a type of quality that will draw others to lead alongside of you. So while I congratulate and thank Mr. Abitiello for a lifetime of service to our students, I'm also pleased to share that his passion for teaching still burns strong. And although he is retiring, we will have him back in our high school next year on a part-time basis so that future students can continue to be inspired by his positive energy and love of mathematics. Congratulations, Neil Abitiello, on what has been a wonderful career in Dobbs Ferry. Have a great summer, and we will see you in September. So just as we take these individual lessons from the people, whether directly or indirectly, as is the case with our retirees, we also take a final lesson. For all of you, it's choose a path in life based on your passion and not based on money. One quality that is consistent among our retirees is burning passion for their work. And when you follow your passion in life, whatever it may be, you will find a level of personal fulfillment and intrinsic reward that will make you feel like you've never worked a day in your life. It will inspire you to pour your heart and soul into all that you do. And with that, you will soon find yourself on a path that allows you to rise to the top of your profession, whatever profession or pursuit that may be. And that by chasing your passion and not money, you will also probably be pleasantly surprised to find that the money will soon follow you. The legacy of this graduating class is forever etched into the history of our school, and you now will join a long line of graduates, teachers, and staff who have followed their passion, contributed beyond themselves, and went on to live wonderful and fulfilling lives. It has been an honor to serve as your principal over these past 4 years. I thank you all for allowing me to be part of such an important time in your lives, and I wish you all the very best as you leave us here today. Congratulations to the class of 2022. At this time, it is with great pleasure that I introduce the salutatorian of the Dobbs Ferry High School class of 2022. So this year's salutatorian is a full IB diploma candidate and is a National Merit commended student who is also a member of both our National Honor Society and French Honor Society. As a three-year science research student, our salutatorian interned at the Albert Einstein College of Medicine and earned first place in medicine and health at the Westchester Rockland Junior Science and Humanities Symposium. She also placed in the medicine and health category in WestCEF as both a junior and senior and won the Society for In Vitro Biology Award in 2021. Outside of the classroom, our salutatorian served as a peer tutor and was also a member of both our Math League and Sign Language Club. She is also an active member of our Dobbs Ferry community and served as a Girl Scout ambassador where she volunteered with the Dobbs Ferry PTSA, Ronald McDonald House, Family to Family, and Toys for Tots. Next fall, our salutatorian will continue her academic career at William & Mary as a Monroe Scholar, a grant given to students to fund their undergraduate research starting in freshman year. In doing so, she will enroll as a double major in both biology and women's studies. It is my distinct pleasure to introduce the salutatorian of the Dobbs Ferry High School class of 2022, Olivia Maltz.
I welcome the parents, teachers, administrators, and guests who have joined my class on this, well, windy Saturday morning. Being named this year's salutatorian has been one of my greatest honors, and I cannot neglect to thank the dedicated teachers who have guided my education over the last 4 years. To my parents, thank you for always having faith in my abilities and for teaching me how to believe in myself. To my siblings, Aaron and James, thank you for providing me with an example of a hardworking student. To my Girl Scout troop leaders, Lisa Salvetti and Susie Brunnenhaus, thank you for showing me the value of generosity and the power of a strong woman. And of course, to the class of 2022, I cannot imagine a greater group of individuals to have grown up with. Today, I will be speaking to you all about change. As Heraclitus, the ancient Greek philosopher, defined it, change is the only constant in life. In other words, the single thing that we can rely on to always be present in our lives and in the world is change. However, I believe that Heraclitus' quote overlooks the complexity of the word. Often fear arises with the prospect of change. It is human behavior to find security and comfort in routine and instinctively not want to break free from the known in fear of the unknown. Perhaps the fear that materializes with the thought of change is just as deserving of the word constant as is change itself. History suggests that this assertion is valid. In the 17th century, Galileo advocated for the heliocentric model, where the sun is at the center of our solar system. Heliocentrism, however, went against the long-standing belief that the Earth was at the center of our world. If Galileo's findings were correct, then the bones that comprise the skeleton that is society would be fractured. The truths that had been instituted for centuries would no longer be the facts of life. The church's preachings would no longer be credible. And so instead of addressing Galileo's findings, they locked him up. It was not only Galileo who was imprisoned, but also scientific progress. Fear halted a scientific breakthrough. Graduates, fear becomes dangerous when it begins to stunt reform, growth, and betterment. When the world becomes static, it is unable to attain its greatest potential. Our world will inevitably go through changes. There will be new technology and novel innovations. What is significantly more important than those two things, however, is how we will change the world to become a more loving and accepting place. will we be able to overcome inequality and discrimination. More money, technology, and innovations will be less relevant if the world is still a place of hatred. It will be in our hands to ensure that the world progresses in a positive way. We must not pass the injustices of today off to the next generation to solve. It will be our responsibility to create a better tomorrow for ourselves, the people of today, and future generations. Change is also complex in the sense that it requires pioneers. My great-grandmother grew up in Ireland. Wanting a better life at 21 years old, she left the only home she had ever known. With only a few pounds in her pockets and the equivalent of an elementary school education, she set sail for Ellis Island, settling down just north of New York City. Here, she would clean homes and babysit to earn a living. Despite her limited formal education, she knew that hard work and education were essential elements for moving her family forward. Her convictions paved the way for her children and future generations to have a better life. She was a pioneer for my family who changed the course of my lineage and broke the cycle of poverty that burdened her Irish family. Class of 2022, there's a world out there waiting for us to change it. We can be the spark that ignites progress. This world needs independent and forward-thinking pioneers, and we are prepared to rise to the occasion. A need for change is seen in every generation. In 1841, Thomas Paul, a black abolitionist, delivered a speech to the Massachusetts Anti-Slavery Society. A theme woven throughout his words is that each generation is faced with a challenge, and whether or not that challenge is overcome is up to the people within that generation. Paul does not, however, claim it is easy. A society dominated by prejudices, Paul argues, clips the wings of genius. Thomas Paul and his colleagues had to fight tirelessly so that no human would ever again be the property of another human. A truth so obvious today was in Paul's time considered revolutionary. Class of 2022, as we consider change, I will leave you all with this. On the Basis of Sex is a movie based on the life of Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. In the closing arguments of Moritz versus Commissioner, a case about gender discrimination, Ginsburg states to the people of the court, "You are being urged to protect the culture and traditions and morality of an America that no longer exists." Simply put, the judges were being asked to uphold precedents that reflected an outdated America. Graduates, we must ask ourselves if we live in an environment that supports the people that comprise it. Are lawmakers passing legislations that reflect the current climate of our world? Are they going to rise to the occasion and move with the flow of change? We must not allow our world to become stagnant. It is our right and obligation to move, to steer the world forward. And finally, I urge you to treat others with respect and kindness, to be an advocate for the underdog, and of course, look for opportunities to be a person for others. As you all go out and set the world on fire, never forget to do so with an open mind and an open heart. I wish you all the best of luck, safety, and most importantly, love. Congratulations.
Nice job, Olivia. And I'm telling you, it's not easy speaking up here with this wind. It's a very nice job. At this time, I would like to introduce our octet, led by Georgia DeFalco. And before they get started, I'd also like to just give a special thank you again to Georgia DeFalco. You've probably heard me do this at a couple of different occasions. Georgia has really led the way as our high school has truly moved to being a true school for the arts. And that was on full display this year with our production of Les Mis. And there are so many seniors here that are graduating with this class who had a direct role in that. And it was a really amazing time for our school and an amazing moment. So congratulations to all of them. And here's George DeFalco and the octet.
Thank you.
now my pleasure to introduce our senior class advisor, Ms. Dana Malloy. Ms. Malloy is now completing her fourth year at Dobbs Ferry High School and teaches all levels of physics. Ms. Malloy has served as the class advisor for this group of seniors since they started as freshmen and has been actively involved with so many activities and moments for our graduates, including our senior science, our Dobbs Ferry High School virtual commons Instagram page, MAC field days, and of course this year's senior prom. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Dana Malloy to the podium.
Congratulations.
It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce to the podium for the final time our superintendent of schools, Dr. Lisa Brady. In addition to her 11 years of serving as our superintendent here at Dobbs Ferry, she has had an incredible 36 years in education. During her career, Dr. Brady served as a health teacher and supervisor of health for 10 years in the Trenton Public Schools before moving into building administration as both an assistant principal and then principal in the 100th Central High School District. For the past 19 years, Dr. Brady has served as a superintendent of schools, first in the South 100th Regional High School District and then the 100th Central Regional High School District, and then joined us same year that I came in at 2011, in 2011. She and I have made 11 walks together, so this is a very, very bittersweet moment, but it is my distinct pleasure to introduce to the podium for the final time, Dr. Lisa Brady.
Has been so far and by far the biggest blessing in my life. In closing, I will share a piece of the famous poem by William Wordsworth, which became a central theme in perhaps the most famous movie ever filmed in Dobbs Ferry, the 1961 classic Splendor in the Grass, which was filmed right here in town and at Dobbs Ferry High School. What though the radiance that was once so bright be now forever taken from my sight, though nothing can bring back the hour of splendor in the grass, of glory in the flower, we will grieve not, rather find strength in what remains behind. I will never forget you. God bless you, and may he keep you in the palm of his hand. Congratulations.
It is now my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian of the Dobbs Ferry High School class of 2022. This year's valedictorian is a full IB diploma candidate, a National Merit Scholarship winner, and a two-year science research student whose project in computer science received the Science Champion Award from the United States Agency for International Development. Additionally, he was a member of the Math League and History Bowl clubs, as well as a violinist in the high school orchestra and River Arts Jazz Band. Our valedictorian is also a three-sport athlete, running cross country in the fall, playing basketball in the winter, and running track in the spring. He participated in cross country for all 6 years, from seventh grade to senior year. He was a two-year varsity basketball player, including his junior year in which his team won the Lower Westchester Regional Championship. He was a four-year spring track athlete, running the 800 meters as well as the 4x800 meter and 4x400 meter relay teams. Our valedictorian is also an active member of the Dobbs Ferry community. He was a frequent volunteer at the Dobbs Ferry Food Pantry, Dobbs Ferry Summer Basketball League, and helped run the Spring Community Partners Summer Program, Project Explore. Next fall, our valedictorian will continue his academic career at Northwestern University, where he plans to study economics. It is my distinct pleasure to introduce the valedictorian of the Dobbs Ferry High School class of 2022, Ben Freed.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Dobbs Ferry class of 2022, I would like to thank everyone who got us here and everyone who makes Dobbs Ferry High School great. Thank you first to the Board of Education for your constant efforts to improve Dobbs Ferry's curriculum, funding, and everything else. Thank you to the administration for maintaining excellence in our school. Thank you to the teachers for teaching us content, but more importantly, teaching us method, how to think and how to solve problems. Thank you to the custodial staff, the food service staff, and all other staff members who work in this district. Thank you so much to the parents who make this so much more than an educational institution. We are a community because of you. And thank you again to the parents for the invaluable lessons you teach that are not easily learned in school. On a personal level, I would like to thank my own parents, Ellen and Ron, for fostering my love for learning. I wouldn't be up here without you two. Thanks, Mom and Dad. I would like to thank my brothers, all eight of you. I've always believed that the blood of the covenant is thicker than the water of the womb, and you guys prove that. Thank you to all of my friends for filling my life with joy and helping me get through the rough patches. Thank you to my coaches for kindling my competitive fire while simultaneously teaching me that sports are about so much more than just winning. And thank you to everyone else who impacted my life, no matter how small. These impacts have shaped me into the person I am today, and that's a person that I am proud of, so thank you. But most of all, class of 2022, I think we should all take a moment to thank ourselves. After all, you were the ones who toiled over homework and projects, stressed and studied for exams, all while navigating your way through high school. You were the ones who woke up early and often stayed late with practices, rehearsals, and other after-school activities. You were the ones who persevered, who sacrificed, and who earned every ounce of your success. Yes, the support we all received was incredible, but it was still you who did this. No one can live your life for you, and you lived it for the past 4 years. Congratulations. Being valedictorian has some nice perks. For example, I get this cool medal, but it also has some drawbacks. For example, I have to give a speech at graduation? I've never been much of a public speaker, So in my formative process for this speech, I decided to consult my most trusted ally, an ally that has been with me through thick and thin, an ally that I've used for many assignments through school, YouTube. And in my time spent watching other valedictorian speeches on YouTube, I learned that many valedictorians use this platform to synthesize the high school experience of their class. So I've sifted through the years, trying to find those moments which made the high school experience. And even just this year, there were plenty of those moments. In the fall, we saw both the football and volleyball teams win sectional titles. The cross-country team sent two runners to states. And who could forget about Mac Field Day, featuring the inaugural Mac Mile, epic performances in the talent show, and culminating in a dominant senior win. Throughout the year, largely thanks to the efforts of the Dobbs Ferry legislative branch, we had not one but three pep rallies, celebrating athletes from every season. And just recently, we have seen our phenomenal musicals return with full live audiences as the team put together an amazing rendition of Les Mis. But while parsing through these moments, I had a nagging feeling that the story was incomplete. What about the days where nothing special happened? The run-of-the-mill, nine-period school day? By definition, these average days constituted most of our time in high school, but yet they never seem to get mentioned in these speeches. Unfortunately, it isn't quite possible for me to encapsulate these days adequately. With 118 kids in this grade, that means that cumulatively, we have spent 472 years in high school. That's kind of absurd to think about. To put that number into perspective, 472 years ago, William Shakespeare hadn't even been born. And when considering the immense diversity of this grade, a grade full of athletes, thespians, academics, artists, writers, future public servants, and beyond the labels, 118 different people with vastly different ideas, experiences, lives. I gave up trying to synthesize the complete story. Class of 2022, remember that while the book of high school contains some chapters which we all share, the majority of the pages are written in invisible ink, available only to the eyes of a single or select few group of students. And while these pages may be joyous, they may also be the opposite. You never know what someone else is going through, what obstacles they might be struggling with, what battles they might be fighting. It is inexcusable not to be kind, receptive, and empathetic. Act so that you become a part of their story, a part worth remembering. As we continue into our adult lives, it's important to acknowledge the control we have over our futures. I could continue with the metaphor, ending this speech with the adage, "Be the author of your own story." But honestly, I think it's a little misleading. There's context that you need to completely understand that quote. Just like high school, most of your life will not be, in a traditional sense, story-worthy. Not every day features a significant plot point, and often there's no climax to be built to. Considering this, it is easy to stop writing in the lulls, selectively authoring the noteworthy moments. But by doing so, you allow the majority of your life to go unwritten, or worse, allow someone else to write it for you. So yes, be the author of your own story, but acknowledge that the story you're writing is not a plot-based narrative. It's your life, and it doesn't always follow a logical path towards a conclusion. It twists and turns, doubles back at times, and you're gonna get lost, but you have to keep writing. As you document the details, good, bad, and ugly, remember, well, what you're writing is important. What's more important is the fact that you're writing it. never put the pen down. Thank you.
Ago, you each received a letter from Mrs. Haggerty explaining how to get your IB course scores when they're released in July. This is really important information. It's so important that Mrs. Haggerty is going to be emailing you again on Monday with the same information. So please be sure to read that letter and keep those login credentials handy. And that goes for every single one of you because you will be getting scores. So in the year 2000, the first cohort of diploma candidates graduated from Dobbs Ferry High School. There were seven of them. That was the end of my very first full year teaching here in Dobbs Ferry. In 2012, after my first diploma cohort graduated, and at the end of Dr. Brady and Dr. Foligno's first year in Dobbs, we had 12 full diploma candidates. Each of those years, there were some students who took IB courses, but not everyone did. Now, as you all sit here about to graduate, I am so very, very pleased to say that every single one of you in the class of 2022 is an IB student. You've all participated in the middle years program and in the diploma program. You have all taken IB diploma courses throughout 11th and 12th grades. Many of you also went for the full diploma, taking six courses over 2 years, writing a 4,000 word extended essay, participating in creativity, activity, and service, and taking the theory of knowledge course. As a matter of fact, 44 of you did this. Especially proud to say and happy that included several of you who at one time also participated in the English as a New Language program here at Dobbs Ferry Schools. In acknowledgement of this tremendous effort, I ask now for the 44 of you who are full diploma candidates to just stand up real quick. That's a lot of you. Thank you. I wish you all the best, all of you, in your future endeavors, and I know you all will keep the attributes of the IB Learner Profile as a guide for whatever lies ahead of you. All the best to all of you, always.
Okay, we are about at the end here, but before we introduce our graduates, a tradition we started here at the high school, I lose track, I'm gonna guess around 2019, was we started to incorporate student voice with an audio of our students sharing their memories of Dobbs Ferry High School and what they will miss most about it. This year, two of our seniors, Hannah Kovach and Julian Batshaw, worked with Mr. Falconetti and Mr. Petrillo to put this together. So before we introduce our graduates, we will just play that through the speakers.
My favorite memory of Dobbs Ferry High School was when we filled Miss Henry's whiteboard with doodles over every class.
One of my favorite memories in high school is reading on the hot tub room with the funniest English class ever.
My favorite memory is definitely doing Les Mis, because that was amazing.
My favorite memory in high school is during that field day. Being together as a grade and competing
Sorry, grades.
My favorite memory at Dobbs Ferry High School was when we got the cast list for Les Mis. I remember being in the car with my best friend and learning that we were going to be playing husband and wife. And I was so excited to have such an amazing cast, and the show turned out amazing. And I was so happy to do that.
I think the moments has to be gym classes and just having fun, whether it be 1v1 in the Coach Cups or just always playing basketball with my friends.
My favorite memory at Dobbs Ferry High School is the closing night of Les Mis before the show, where everyone was just talking about how much they were going to miss theater and how much they appreciated everyone there, and it makes me cry every time I think about it. I just felt so appreciated, and I felt so close with everyone there. It was amazing.
My all-time favorite high school memory would probably have to be my senior night in football. It's a big honor. I've always looked on to it. And we also got to honor a very special person in the football community named Scotty. And it was very important. It's a very good memory that will stay for me for the rest of my life.
My favorite memory in high school was definitely science research and all the musicals.
What I'm going to miss the most about high school is the overwhelming support everyone has for each other, whether it be everyone showing up to football games, everyone showing up to the musicals. Everyone's always there for everyone and here to support.
My favorite memory at Dobbs Ferry is all the math field days over the years.
My favorite memory from Dobbs Ferry High School was taking my last bow for Les Mis with all the friends I've made over the years doing theater together.
My favorite memory in Dobbs Ferry High School was convincing every person I met to join track, and it actually worked.
My favorite memory from Dobbs Ferry is when Julian got stuck in his hair.
What do you mean the first of Dobbs is a small tech-knit community in the school spirit, especially at football games? It's super prevalent, and it's amazing to see the entire community come together in blue and white. I'm also really going to miss the friendships I've made with people I've grown up with since kindergarten, and even friends I've made just this year, as well as the relationships I've been able to form with all of my teachers.
Okay, so I have three things I'm going to miss Mr. Falconetti, and I'm also going to miss Mr. Fishbeck and Mr. Cott, who always have some good jokes about my personality and character.
What I'll miss most about high school is how our grade always comes together like a family, and how we always have our own pep rallies and parties.
I will definitely miss the people the most, because this is the sixth year that I've lived in Dobbs, and that's the longest I've been able to live somewhere. I've really been able to form amazing friendships with so many people I love so much, and I'm going to miss them so much too, but I can confidently say that these are friendships that I will have for my whole life, which is something I'm really, really grateful for, and something that I think Dobbs for.
The thing I'm going to miss most about high school is the people that I grew up with.
One thing I'll miss about high school is how my classes managed to bring me and my classmates together and turn us into little families. We would always text each other, stay up late, we would help each other with little things and big things, and we would always just be there for each other.
My favorite memories from Dobbs Ferry High School would have to be the many rehearsals from Les Mis, being able to not only just let it out on stage, but also make many friends along the way that otherwise I wouldn't be able to make.
From Dobbs, what I'm gonna miss the most is coming in every day and being able to see all my friends and hang out with everyone, because it's nice to be together in the classroom with everyone and crack jokes together because we've all grown up with each other. So I'm gonna miss being able to see everyone.
I love being a part of Mac Field Day again this year and seeing how much joy and excitement, enthusiasm they have for that day, and how much fun they had. So I loved experiencing that with them this year. And also have a lot of wonderful memories with the seniors that played football, watching them grow the last few years and seeing them accomplish a lot this year was really a product of their hard work and how much they put into it. And it really was a joy to be around them and be there with them for that journey.
I'd like to wish my students from the class of 22 the best of luck in all you do. I will miss my daily roasts of all of you. Take care.
The best thing about the class of 2022 is their enthusiasm for learning, their curiosity, and the great personalities that make up this group. Even the most quiet will shock you with the things that they've done, whether it be on the stage, on the field, and in the classroom. Thank you for making one of the best years of my teaching career. Congratulations.
My favorite memory from the class of 2022 would have to be the Six Flags trip that we went on for science research. We had an incredible time, and it was just a celebration of, you know, how much work and you know, dedication had gone into the program over the years.
Take pride in how far you have come. Have faith in how far you can go. And don't forget to enjoy the journey.
All right, it's that time we've all been waiting for. It's my honor to present to you the class of 2022. Will the first row of graduates please stand and make your way towards the stage. Louis Albanese. Kayla Albert. Jonathan Olmaris Martinez. Miguel Angel Alvarez III. Jair Arcos. Brandon M. Astreicher. Julian Adorama. David Leonardo Ibar. Frida Bayek. Devin Barbera. Gabriel Barnett. Julian Batshaw. Ella Bernheimer. Leon Bibaraj. Brianna Bongiovanni. Kat Bradley. Taylor Broccoli. Mark Broughton. Madeline Brunenaus. Ryan James Brunenaus. Alessia Valente Bubula. Caitlin Burt. Aaliyah Buzurakova. Nigel Cheatham. William Cintron. Alexandra Paige Cochran. Zane Oliver Cunningham. Felix Shedefher Danishman. Olivia Deakins. Anthony DelVito. Brendan Dubilier. David Farnsworth. Elizabeth Feingold. Thomas Fontana. Benjamin Freed. Ram Gabule. Adam Galland. Sammy Georgiadakis. Edward Gormley. Genevieve Rose Greco. Nicholas J. Green. Samuel G. Gregorio. Ira Guru Prasad. Adeline Haddad. Kieran Hartheimer. Olivia Rose Elizabeth Hasbrook. Paula A. Hernandez. Emma Ifremoff. Emmanuel Ifremoff. Kotaro Ida. Austin Canapin. Physicon. Kristen N. Kikuchi. Dylan Klein. Joseph S. Kleinman. Hannah Paige Kovach. Chloe Dane Liberton. Robert Levitt. Preston Long. Dylan Lucchese. Mark Lucchese. Amanda Maglione. Karam Malouf. Samantha Marine Lopez. Jabari Marsland. Martin Mashaloff. James Jacob Masterson. Rachel Eva Masterson. Jack Christopher Matisse. Alexander Mays Conway. Liberty McCormick. Matthew McCormick. Roberto Melkor. Endrit Meshi. Matthew Miatelitz. Olivia Mary Maltz. Devanji Montan Pichardo. Madison Alexis Moore. Aaron Morganowski. Luke G. Mullins. Alexander Mulismani. Ava Joanna Nunez. Danny O'Neill. Anthony Pinero. Annabelle Patino. Jacob Ronan King. Christian Perez. Franca Pessin. Emma Prala. Chaya Rajani Bangzer. Claudio Rao. Marcellino Rao. Jose Luis Regalado. Natalia Reith, Isabel Rose Rivera Ojeda, Aiden Romano, Joseph Romano, Zara Rust, Leonelis Sanchez, Robert Sanzo, Esther Schreiber, Adam Schwartz, Jacob Saletti, Nasser Smith, Ava Solis, Ryan Sparta, Drew Spielberger, Melissa St. John, Daniel Stern, Caitlin Storms, Trishti Tandon, Isabel Taylor, Remy Turjanian, Kiernan Van Engen, Emily Vassalotti, Giovanni Williams, Sophia Zamora Morales.
Graduates, please rise. By the power vested in me by the Dobbs Ferry Union Free School District and the Commissioner of the New York State Department of Education, I now pronounce all of you graduates of the Dobbs Ferry High School Class of 2022. You can throw them.
That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. Everybody